रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास। माय नेम इज़ बिलाल अकरम एंड माय प्रेजेंटेशन टॉपिक इज़ मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज़ ऑफ एडवांस मटेरियल। देयर आर डिफरेंट प्रॉपर्टीज़ ऑफ एडवांस मटेरियल लाइक इलेक्ट्रिकल प्रॉपर्टीज़, डाइलेक्ट्रिक प्रॉपर्टीज़, ऑप्टिकल प्रॉपर्टीज़, मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज़, केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज़ एंड मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज़। First of all, we will discuss about mechanical properties of advanced materials. The key concepts are mechanical properties, stress, strain, hardness, strength, plasticity, ductility, brittleness, toughness, malleability. Advanced materials are nanomaterials. Properties of advanced materials, mechanical properties and application. When we talk about mechanical properties, then we should know that what are mechanical properties. The properties that which can be determined or observed by application of mechanical force or load are known as mechanical properties. Now, what is mechanical force? Mechanical force is a force that requires direct physical contact. Further, the properties of material that determine its behavior under applied forces are known as mechanical properties. They are usually related to the elastic and plastic behavior of the material. These properties are expressed as a function of stress, strain, etc. A sound knowledge of mechanical properties of materials provides the basis for predicting behavior of materials under different load conditions and designing the components out of them. Stress and strain. Experience shows that any material subjected to a load may either deform, yield, or break depending on the magnitude of load, nature of the materials. It means that when we exert a force on a material, the material may undergo deformations or break. It will depend upon the magnitude of load. It means that how much force we are exerting on that material, and it will also depend upon the nature of that material. Now, what is stress? It is internal resisting force offered by the body to resist the deformation per unit cross section area of the body. Mathematically, the stress is expressed as a force divided by cross sectional area. From figure you can see that on the left hand side of the figure a material is placed and we are exerting a force on both side of that materials, and A naught is the cross sectional area of that material. Stress is represented by the symbol of sigma and is equal to force divided by cross sectional area, F over A naught. F is the force and A naught is the cross sectional area of the material. Now, what is strain? Strain is the dimensional response given by material against mechanical loading deformation produced per unit length. Mathematically, strain is change in length divided by original length. So we can say that the strain is the ratio of change of length divided by original length of that materials. Strain formula is equal to del L over L. Del L is equal to change in length, and L is the original length of the materials before exerting the force. The next term is hardness. It is the property of material that resist penetration. The next term is strength. The property of material that resist the external load without breaking. It determines the ability of a material to withstand stress without failure. The maximum stress that any material will withstand before destruction is called ultimate strength. It means that if we exert a force on a material and that material will resist against that force without breaking, then this property of that material is known as its strength. The next term is elasticity. The property of material by which it returns to its original shape after removal of load. It means that when we exert a force on any material, that material will change its position. from original position, and when we remove that force, the material will come back to its original position. Then this property of material is known as its elasticity. The property of material by virtue of which deformation caused by applied load disappears upon removal of load. Elasticity of a material is the power of coming back to its original position after deformation when the stress or load is removed. From the figure on the left hand side, there is no force acting on that materials, and in the middle, when we applied a force on a material, the material will change its position from main position, and when we remove that force, the material will come back to its original position. So we can say that elasticity is a reversible property of the material. The next term is plasticity, the property of material by which permanent deformation take place after removal of load or force. This property is known as plasticity. It means that when we applied a force on a material, the material change in its length, and when we remove that force, the material will not come back to its original shape. Then this property is known as plasticity. The plasticity of a material is its ability to undergo some degree of permanent deformation without rupture or failure. Plastic deformation will take only after the elastic limit is exceeded. It increases with increase in temperature. From the figure, you can see on the left hand side, there is no force acting on that material. And when we exert a force on that material, the material will change its position from main position. And when we remove that force, the material will slightly come back to its original position, but the plane still stretched. Here is a graph. This graph shows stress strain curve. On x-axis we will take strain, and on y-axis we will take stress that we applied. So in first you can see elastic deformation, and when we applied a stress on that material, the material will come back to its original shape after that red line. After that, when we further applied stress, the material will change its length from original length but will not break. Further applying more stress, there will necking appear before breaking. The material will become more weak, but at a point when you applied more force, the material will break. The next term is ductility, the property of material by which it can drawn into thin wires without any rupture. The next term is brittleness, the property of material in which no deformation take place by the external load and it may break or rupture. Glass is the example of brittleness. Toughness, the property of material by which it can bend, twist and stretch under a high stress without any rupture. It means that if we applying a high stress or force on a material, and that material can bend, twist and stretch, then this property is known as toughness of that material. The next term is malleability. The malleability of a material is its ability to be flattened into thin sheets without cracking by hot or cold working. Gold is the most malleable metal. By applying a force with hammer, we can convert it into the thin sheet. Advanced materials. An advanced materials can be said to be a material which has engineered properties created through the development of specialized process and synthesis technology. Advanced material wo material hote hain jinko aap kisi specific properties ke liye specific method aur specific process ke zariye synthesis karte hain, यानी कि आपको जिस तरह की प्रॉपर्टीज़ रिक्वायर्ड होती हैं उसी के अकॉर्डिंग जो आप लोग मटेरियल्स बनाते हैं उनको हम एडवांस मटेरियल कहते हैं। द नेक्स्ट टर्म इज़ नैनो मटेरियल्स आर नैनो पार्टिकल्स। यू आर फेमिलियर विद दिस टर्म। नैनो पार्टिकल्स आर पार्टिकल बिटवीन 1 and 100 नैनोमीटर्स इन साइज। इन नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी अ पार्टिकल इज़ डिफाइंड एज अ स्मॉल ऑब्जेक्ट डैट बिहेव एज अ होल यूनिट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू प्रॉपर्टीज़। पार्टिकल्स ऑफ एनी शेप विद डिमेंशन इन द 10^-9 एंड 10^-7 मीटर रेंज आर कॉल्ड नैनो पार्टिकल्स आर नैनो मटीरियल्स। मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज़ ऑफ एडवांस मटीरियल्स। नैनो पार्टिकल्स शो डिफरेंट मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज़ रिलेटिव टू माइक्रो पार्टिकल्स एंड बल्क मटीरियल्स। बल्क मटीरियल्स आर बिगर इन साइज एज कम्पेयर टू माइक्रो पार्टिकल्स प्रोवाइडिंग मोर इफेक्टिव ऑप्शंस फॉर द सरफेस मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ मैनी डिवाइसेस इन द मैकेनिकल स्ट्रेंथ आर टू इम्प्रूव द क्वालिटी ऑफ नैनो मैनुफैक्चरिंग नैनो फैब्रिकेशन etc। पार्टिकल्स साइज रिडक्शन टू नैनोमीटर स्केल्स पोजेस न्यू टेक्नोलॉजिकल चैलेंजेस सच एज पार्टिकल एग्लोमरेशंस। द मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ नैनो मटीरियल्स इंक्रीज विद डिक्रीज इन साइज बिकॉज स्मॉलर द साइज लेसर इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ फाइंडिंग इम्परफेक्शंस सच एज डिसलोकेशंस वैकेंसीज ग्रेन बाउंड्रीज। स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटीरियल्स इम्प्रूव सिग्निफिकेंटली एज द पार्टिकल साइज डिक्रीज ड्यू टू द परफेक्ट डिफेक्ट फ्री सर्फस। Hardness and yield strength of material also increase as particle size is decreased. Elasticity and toughness of material also increase as particle size is decreased. In addition to specific properties of interest for a particular application of a material, its elasticity, strength, hardness, brittleness, etc. also determine whether an application is possible. No matter how good the electrical, magnetic, chemical or other properties are, a material is of no use if it does not fulfill mechanical requirement. For example, we have a material, it has good electrical, magnetic, chemical and other properties. So if this material is not mechanically strong, then there is no use of these properties. Mechanical properties usually are anisotropic. They depend on the direction of applied force. A framework of strong covalent bond as in diamond result in high hardness and compressive strength. Diamond is very hard because of presence of framework of strong covalent bond. Characteristics of nanomaterials with respect to mechanical properties. By reducing the grain size, lighter materials with enhanced mechanical properties can be produced. Nano grains are more resistant since they have no defects inside, contrary to micro grains. Nanocrystalline copper is 3 times more resistant than usual copper because nanocrystalline copper has smaller size as compared to usual copper. They are also more ductile since nano grain glide is much easier, so they can convert into the voids. So this is the end of my presentation. The next part will explain by my class fellow Mohammad Naz. Thank you.